Hey, people, what is up? Well, right now I am going to talk about one of my favorite knives. And when I say favorite, I mean easily in the top five. So I'm going to ramble about it, share my thoughts and opinions, and basically let y'all know why it's one of my top five favorites. So in just a second, I'm going to pull it out and I'm going to show y'all. But before I do that, I wanted to show y'all something else. Why? Because I just do. So, let me cut the lights off. Oh, it's about to get freaky up in here. This right here is my Seiko Monster. And I've had it for, I don't know, about 5 years or so now. And in my opinion, Seiko's luminescent paint they put on the markers, the indices, is some of the best in the industry. Check this out, y'all. Just a little bit of charge. Of course, I could have stopped long ago, but natural sunlight will get you good. Check that out. That thing just glows like radioactive. And it'll stay like that for a while. Yep, I highly recommend if you want a nice watch for the money. This Seiko Monster is just about one of the nicest in my opinion. And I was selling it too, and nobody wanted it. Oh well, better for me. But that's neither here nor there. Let's talk about one of my favorite knives. Let me move Shy Girl over here. Well, let's show. I'm going to show you a few of my favorites. This Bradley Mayhem and this 760 Lum and this Millie. Y'all know those are some of my favorites right there. How about this Citadel 92mm, or this 83mm. I love all those. Those are just easily some of my favorites. And of course the ZT-0200, that's up there. These are knives I couldn't do without. Now, top five favorites, I don't know, it depends on the day. I'd have to pick. That'd be hard to do. I know definitely that's two of them right there. Those two, for damn sure. So, there's that. So, what's the one you're talking about, Exacto? Well, didn't y'all read the title? ZT-0301. That's right, y'all. This one's easily in my top five. I just love this blade to death, and I'm going to tell you why. I mean, you got so much to talk about with it, so much that I want to tell y'all about. I might forget some stuff, but nonetheless. And I like to name all my nice blades like this. So her name is Ophelia. Now, Ophelia has beautiful green texture G10. It's just a very beautiful texture on it. I love that. See that arc? Just nice. And then you flip her over, and she has a beautiful backside. Check that out. Same texture on the TI. Frame lock. You got your lock bar stop there. And it's just, the handle feels so good. It's ergonomic. Can't really pick up on any hot spots that bother me. I mean, if you really squeeze down on it, then you can get a little bit of a bite right here and on the shoulders, you know. It's a little bit blocky, but nonetheless, it feels really good. It's not as blocky as a Strider, and this is right here a Strider and Onion collaboration. You can kind of see each knife designer's characteristics. There, you can see their signatures in the knife if you look. So, you know, it's a collab, and I'll talk more about that in a minute. as I mentioned, it has TI here, and it has G10 here. Up front here, you have some S30V, beautiful shaped S30V in my opinion. We'll talk more about that. Let's go over here to the handle. Let's briefly discuss each little area. Well, first of all, like I said, you got the G10 and the TI and a G10 backspacer. And one thing I didn't really care for on the Strider SMF I had is on this side you have solid G10. Well, on this one you have G10 and you have a spacer, which I believe that's titanium as well. Could be wrong about that, but I believe that is titanium. And either way, nonetheless, it's metal. And what that does is, besides give you just a little bit more strength whenever you're bars here, your stop, blade stop, I'll talk about that in a minute, when it hits up here, it's going to not wear on that G10, it's going to hit the metal before it hits the G10. On the Striders, you know, you have to go, whenever they wear out on one side or whatever, and they get kind of loose, you have to get a condom put on there, and, you know, I wasn't crazy about that, but whatever. So, you know, I like that liner in there. The G10 backspacer has some texturing down here. See there? And it's a pretty good texturing. Now, what that would do is, if you had it in reverse grip, you can get a nice, you know, purchase right there. I guess if your hands are long enough, or, you know, wide enough, or if you wanted to extend it a little bit, you get a little bit in the palm, too. Right here, on your spine, or your handle area, and the spine, you have some nice, what kind of looks like scalloping, what I usually call scalloping, but this is actually functional, so actually, you know, bites in and really does give you a good grip. It's pretty sharp on the shoulders there inside and outside, so it does give you a nice functional grip, and you can see on the blade tang there, see there? That right there comes up nicely and just forms with the handle. I mean, the grooves are cut in there perfectly. Looks beautiful too. So it does give you some nice functional use there. Down to the blade, you got this little area right here. See that? And if you wanted to come up past that jimping, you could get a little bit of a grip up here. Put your thumb in there. You got more leverage, more power. That is to say, and then it jumps back up and gradually drops, comes back around, nice belly to a little recurve, excellent cutter. I'll demonstrate that in a minute. Look at the grind lines on this thing. Beautiful flats and grinds everywhere. And if you watch some of my other reviews, like, I don't know, the ZT 03 or 0200 here, and, you know, a few others, you'll probably hear me talking about how I like how the blade stock is thick, then it narrows down with that little swedge up top, and then it kind of just, you know, penis heads back out to form that reinforced tip. I just like that. That's really kick-ass in my opinion. It looks good, and, you know, it is somewhat functional in that it takes a little material away from the blade to lighten it up a little bit. You know, just very minuscule amounts, but nonetheless, it makes a nice look, and that's what I like. Your flipper down here. Your flipper extends up here, so you can flip it, of course. And you see whenever it's closed, everything's nice and flush. And when it's open, it makes a nice cutout there with the guard. And like I say, everything's nice and flush up here, too, on the top. So everything just fits good. The fit and finish, I like it a lot. It is primarily a flipper design, and you might think that these thumb studs, or these blade stops, rather, are thumb studs. Not necessarily. I mean, they can be used as such, but it's not the easiest or the best way to do it, in my opinion. You can get behind there and push them, and, you know, it does work. But I find the best and easiest way for me, since I especially carry it tip up, just pull it out. Your finger's already there anyway. Just pull back whenever you pull it out of your pocket. And there you go. Now, if you do that, you know, if you're sitting there flipping it a lot, it can abrade your finger, make it tender, because these are really rough, but, you know, man up and, you know, make sure you got a dick between your legs instead of a pussy, so no problem there. One thing to note, it's not a big issue for me because it's just not, but if it is to you, you might want to note this. See the liner, or the frame lock, rather? If you squeeze down on the top of the blade up here, you know, compress it, you can see that? Moves the frame lock down in toward the rest of the titanium, which is not a big deal, but just something to note. It will be there if it's an issue. Either way, I don't think it's going to bother with the frame lock, and I think if anything, if you squeeze it down, it'll keep it locking up a little bit tighter, in my opinion. You know, just if you look at the overall mechanics of it here, you do have your stabilizer, so you don't overextend it. I don't find that that's 100% necessary. I don't really see that you would overextend it too easily. I mean, I guess you could if you got adrenaline or something, you just whatever. Not a problem. I've never hyperextended a frame lock. You do have options for mounting the clip anywhere you want, down here. You know, you got your snake bites up here. Snake bites here. And then that's where I put it. Got my grip tape on there. Now, note that if you mount it on this side, you get them, you know, pretty much in line, kind of centered up. Here, here, down here, the same thing, centered up, sort of. And up here, you're going to get it offset, see, because of the pivot. So if that's an issue, then it is not an issue to me. I don't put it on that side anyway. Now, let's see, what else we want to talk about? Pocket clip's good. Just your standard kind of Kershaw deal. Same one is on the 0200. Same one is on the Kershaw Skyline, if I'm not mistaken. It's sturdy. Real sturdy. You got to really bend out on it, but it's rounded and it's smooth. And it just goes in and comes out of the pocket with ease. Not an issue. I like this pocket clip. Leaves about that much out of the top, which is fine by me. It's a good-looking knife. Maybe I want it to be seen. Anyway, so, good stuff. Fairly heavy. It is a heavier knife, but it's, you know, for heavier use, too. This thing can sustain a lot of use. And as mentioned, my Strider SMF I had, I liked it. I really did, but not enough to keep it, or not enough to buy another one. And if given a choice, and I could only have one of them between the Strider SMF and this, I take this hands down. I think it's a better knife. Same materials. Talking about TI, G10 on one side, and S30V. So, all things considered, I think this is the better knife. My opinion. I know there comes the ass hurtings, but, you know, that's what it is. It's my opinion. How about the hardware? Well, hardware is great, and you know me, I love a good screw. Right here, you have your Torx, and I had this thing apart, and I'll talk about that a bit in a minute. I had it apart, messing with it, cleaning it, you know, just getting it all right, and these screws are solid all the way through, pretty, you know, good diameter, solid screws, straight through to the other side. You see, there's the other side, straight through. Whereas something like the 0200 here has your Torx, and you got your barrel spacers, and then you got your Torx on the other side, so, you know, they come in from both sides. This is just a solid screw, straight through, long screw, all the way here. And then here you have your same type of deal. It's a big nut. That's right, y'all. Gotta love big nuts. And on the other side, you have your little hex bolt top deal, which is, you know, countersunk in there, flush. And it's a good diameter, too. You can see the screw diameter right there in the center. And then when you unscrew this, you know, it's a good size bolt. So, and it's just a good pivot. It's a real good pivot. Yeah, maybe the Strider's pivot is a little bit beefier, but then again, I don't see you fucking this one up. So, hey, you know, to each their own. Not a pry bar, but you certainly could pry with this thing, I'm convinced. Not that I'm going to do it and screw up my beautiful Tiger Striped S30V, but if I had to. But, you know, I carry a pry bar for that. So, nonetheless, I'm rambling. Where was I going with this? I damn forgot where I was going with this. So, yeah, the pivot's good. Hardware's good. Nothing to complain about there. Okay, so I was inside her, and I was messing around inside her. And I noticed the torsion bar is actually pretty healthy in this one, too. Yes, it is assisted, if you couldn't tell by now. Picks up right about there. And it got a torsion bar. Now, an upside to that is it's going to pretty much pop out every time you do it. Like this one on the 0200, if you kind of just, you know, pussy finger it, you're going to get that. You got to give that one a deliberate flick. This one, if you just kind of pussy finger it, it's still coming out. Granted, it is lumbering, and I'll talk to that in a minute, but it is going to, you know, come out pretty much every time. Now, an upside to the torsion bar is that. The downside to the torsion bar is that it is a spring, and it is subject to failure, as all springs are. Another upside is that Kershaw will most likely send you out a replacement, no questions asked, because Kershaw has one of the best warranties and customer services out there, in my opinion. I've dealt with them a few times, and they're good stuff. So, torsion bar. Another downside is, if you break your torsion bar, or you decide you want to take it out for whatever reason, then that's your detent. Whereas something like this would have a detent, you know, and you're going to pretty much keep the blade closed. You can see it suck in right there. Holds with the detent. This one has no detent per se. It relies on the torsion bar. So if your torsion bar goes tits up, so does your detent, and you'll have a blade just flopping around. Downside. Nonetheless, it's not enough to make me not like this knife. I love this knife. Speaking of that deployment speed, well, just like any flipper, if you give it a little bit more, you know, deliberate pullback and then a flip, kind of a wrist action, you can get it out there quick. However, it's not going to be as quick as some because, you know, it's a mass of steel there, and the larger the mass is going to lumber out a little bit. Something like this, with less steel that got to be kicked out, it's going to come out faster, you know, or this right here. So, it's just physics. Nonetheless, I do like it. I think it's a nice, it's really, you know, it's got some kick to it. Whenever you get that thing out there, it just really does have a positive, good, forceful open. You can kind of see my hand whenever I do it. See, it just vibrates. And, you know, it's a good, solid knife all around. And it's a good action on it. Real smooth. Real smooth action. If you just feel it all the way through. Nothing gritty. And, I don't know, it's just, it's very desirable to me. I cleaned it all up in there and, you know, got everything straightened up the way I wanted. Lock bar, you got a good thick lock bar there. TI, so that's good stuff. You got, I don't know if you can see it on here, a little bit too dark, I guess, but it's got a healthy engagement. It's about 50% engaged right now, and that's good for me. You know, it's just, I like it quite a bit. I keep saying that. But it's just easily one of my favorites. Let me grab a piece of paper and let me show y'all that edge. Now, one big problem. Jaspers, what are you doing? Don't hit the tripod. Hey, back off, fuck nugget. I'll pet you in a minute, buddy. Okay? We'll play with the ball. Oh, yeah, by the way, to adjust that, I like the, I failed to mention this, so I'll do it. I'll get back to what I was saying in a minute. I like the fact that it's a standard, you know, hex type of deal, and you just pull out your tool, like this right here, this expensive tool, Snap-on, best they make, y'all, my opinion. you can pretty much adjust it with a normal standard type of deal. Okay, I like that, but then again, you got Torx back here, which is, depending on who you are, may or may not be standard. You know, you can't always find something to go in there just randomly. You can find a pair of pliers and fix that pivot, which I guess is the most critical area that you might need to mess with. I don't know. Depends on what you're doing, I guess. But you could use a pair of pliers on this. I don't recommend it for non-emergencies because it can mar up your shit. This is much better, but either way, I thought that they should either use like a Phillips or a flat over here. Just make it standard, you know. Make it easier to adjust in the field if you need to take it apart. Just an observation, not enough to keep me from buying it. Now, what I was saying is, one thing I did not like about the Strider, the very expensive SMF that I bought, or, you know, I traded for it, actually, but, you know, still, it was that money out. One thing I didn't like about it is the edge came shitty, okay? And I'm not talking about, like, you know, just needed to be sharpened shitty, like somebody had used it. I'm talking about, like, the edge geometry was shitty. It had a real thick blade stock, similar to this, and just the grind on it to the edge, it was pretty much awful. I had to really reprofile it, and even then, I wasn't completely satisfied with it. I could have spent a lot more time with it, but frankly, I didn't want to. This one, however, factory edge on it came ridiculous. And, of course, I touched it on my ultra-fine stone or rods, and now she just screams through the paper. It's just ridiculously ridiculous. I mean, you know, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, I want a heavy-duty knife, granted. You know, I want a knife that you can really pry with if you wanted to. Not that I would, because I don't think they're designed for that. But I guess you could. It would handle it. But just because it's a tough-ass knife with a thick blade stock don't mean it shouldn't be sharp. It's a damn knife. So, that's one of the reasons. I mean, I don't know how all Striders come. I've only had one, and I'll probably never buy another. Not because of that, but because of a lot of reasons. But if they came like that Strider, then yeah, I'm not crazy about the edge geometry on that. So, my opinions, pluck your pink thong out of your booty crack. Anyway, so, I mean, hands down, this is one of my favorites. And I traded, I traded a FRN Endura. I traded my old Recon 1 with the Ultra Lock, the Axis style lock, which I'm not crazy about anyway. Never was. And I traded my BM Griptilian, which I didn't care for either. So I traded my Endura. And I got this one. Now this one right here, I'm not sure if it's, you know, what the status is of it, but it actually seems kind of hard to find. This one in the, I believe it's the 0302 with the 10, the Coyote 10. That's sexy. That's a sexy one, too. I like the green, too, though. Matches most of my pants that I, you know, wear. I like green. But these are not as easy to find. You can find the 0300, which is pretty much identical, except for blade is all black, handle's all black. So that's the only difference. It's like this one. You know, it's going to look like that, but, you know, this shape, this configuration, this color. And same knife, but I like this one the best. I love that Tiger Striped S30V. You got the DLC thing going on, and then they sandblast it off, or bead blasted it, one of the two. You know, they blast it with some media and take off certain areas, and it looks good. I just think it looks sexy. Reminds me of a snake. Very reptilian looking. But yeah, I mean, this one right here, I'm glad I got it. It's not an easy one to find. It's not cheap when you do. And for the trades I traded it for, I think it's, you know, I'm very, very happy with it. And this one has been in my pocket a lot. Not as much as this girl right here, but quite a bit. So, Oh, another thing I wanted to mention. This goes for a lot of torsion bar knives, actually, or, you know, Kershaw's spring assist. You have a channel in there. Whenever you pop this thing off, you have a channel milled out in there, and you have your torsion bar setting in there. And sometimes people have complained about some of their torsion bar-equipped knives rattling. This one don't. This one's... I'll tell you why. None of mine do, and I'll tell you why. But if you do get a torsion bar and it rattles a little bit, it's because you need to put some grease inside that channel. Just make it kind of sort of sticky. You want a lubricating grease, like, I don't know, something like you would put on a gun rail. That's what I used. I used some of my shooter's choice and just greased it up. And it's kind of sticky to the point where, you know, it keeps shit from loosely, you know, just flopping around. But at the same time, it's going to be viscous enough, I guess you would say, that, you know, it is able to move freely. So that's what you do in that case. Trying to make sure I've covered everything I want to cover here, because, like I said, there's a lot to talk about on this one. I don't know. I think that's about it. I really do love her. This is my new girlfriend, Ophelia. So, if y'all have any questions about Ophelia, or, you know, the 0300, same thing, whatever, this one right here, then down there in the comments, you can ask me. I'll respond. And if you want to comment, message, discuss it, whatever. Talk about whatever you want to talk about. And I guess with that, I'll get on out of here. So there was my review on the 0301 from Zero Tolerance. She's a sexy one, y'all, and I love her. Life's short. Stay sharp.